Amen. You know, I've met some saints, and they've got saved, but they're kind of like Psalm 78 and 42. They remembered not his hand nor the day he delivered them from the enemy. They forgot. Come on. And when you forgot what he really did, he saved you. And you're no longer on your way destined for an eternal flame in hell. Come on, somebody. How in the world could you walk around and let whatever's going on in your life, hard and negative, dictate to your face and to your heart, come on, somebody, to frown and be sad to the point you don't even want to live no more? Come on, somebody. Have you forgot what he done? Have you forgot what he did? Anybody hear Holy Ghost? The Bible said in Acts 13 and 52, the disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Ghost. Somebody say the early church was filled with joy and the Holy Ghost. Wow. Somebody shout, full of the Holy Ghost, but full of joy. That meant their face didn't look like a reprint of the Book of Lamentation. Their face didn't look like they just took a sip of sewer water and lemon juice. Come on, somebody. We'll be happy over there. How about we'll be happy right here? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. When you realize, come on, church. Glory to God, what he saved you from, saint. Some saints, they've got their heart right with God, but somebody needs to donate and give to my Lord. You don't know about that. They have to send a missionary to their face to preach the gospel. Hallelujah. Have you forgot? Have you forgot? It don't matter how hard life is right now. You got to remember what he did at the cross. Come on, somebody. The Bible said in Luke chapter 10, verse 17, the 70 returned with joy, said, even the demons are subject unto us through your name. Man, the early church, the disciples, they were with joy. They were coming to Jesus talking about, boy, we've been preaching in the name of Jesus, casting out devils. They were excited about it. And Jesus told them in verse 20, notwithstanding this, rejoice not just because demons are subject unto you, but rejoice because your name's been written in the Lamb's book of life. Somebody shout when you remember where your name's written. Come on, somebody. You can rejoice. And when you forget that, Psalms 51, David said in verses 12, restore unto me the joy of your salvation. Uphold me with your free spirit. There's a freedom that only comes when it's his salvation. Come on, somebody. David said, God, restore to me the joy of your salvation. It ain't me that saved me. It was you that saved me. It ain't mine. It's yours. Come on, somebody. You're the one that did it. Hallelujah. And it releases a freedom. Praise God. So you don't have to wait till you get over there to be happy. Somebody shout, you'd be happy right here. Proverbs 16 and 20 said, they that trust in the Lord will be happy. Somebody say, happy, 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 happy. Trust him. Hallelujah. Don't forget his hand in the day he set you free. If you do, your face will look like it's upside down. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. You have to put a clothes hanger in some people's mouth to get them smiling more. Hallelujah. And that shouldn't be among the saints. Amen. I mean, I've been some places before. They sang about being happy over there. And you about couldn't even stand to watch them sing about being happy over there. You was almost praying, God, take them on over there. They frowned so much in the choir and in the church, you didn't know when you told them to stand up, amen, glory to God, whether you wanted them to stand on their hands or their feet. Some of them, you want them to stand on their hands so their face would look like a smile, because now it's upside down. Amen, where's the snare drum and the cymbal? Hallelujah, praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.